cook. She got the recipe. She got what you need. That girl can cook. That black girl magic. I gotta have it.
Hey y'all, and welcome back to my channel. And today I'm gonna be showing you guys how to make the absolute best seafood dip. So look, if you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe to my channel and let's go ahead and get started. Alright, so we're going to start off with seasoning our proteins. Today we're dealing with three different types, and right here we have about 5 ounces of salmon and about 10 to 12 extra large shrimp that I have chopped up. Remember, these shrimp are clean, deveined, and the tails are off, alright? So we're going to go in with some seasoning. I'm using Old Bay. This is about 2 teaspoons of Old Bay, and I'm going to divide those in half by basically just giving half of it to the shrimp and half of it to the salmon. All right, and I'm also adding in 2 teaspoons of Creole seasoning, which is going to give it a nice kick. If you don't like the Creole seasoning, you can definitely leave it out. Now listen, you can season this however you want to, honey. It's totally up to you, but just make sure it's seasoned. All right, so look, we're over medium high heat, and we're going to start off with a tablespoon of olive oil, and we're going to get these shrimp going. So add in your shrimp. You really don't need much, and this right here will feed about maybe 8 people, okay? But you're going to add in your shrimp and cook that until it's nice and pink or opaque. Make sure it's cooked all the way through. And we're just going to set that aside until we need it for later, okay? So look, now we're going to work on the next protein. All of this is done in one skillet, all right? So add your seasoned salmon in. You're going to cook it on both sides for about 2 minutes or until it's mostly done. And if you have a different size piece of fillet, you know it might take different times, and that's okay, okay? But you want to try to cook it as much as you can, all right? And once it's done, set it to the side as well. It doesn't take long. All right, so look, we're gonna add in 1 tablespoon of butter to get this thing going, because we are about to sweat some veggies. So look, I'm adding in 1/4 cup of chopped onions, and I'm gonna give that a quick mix. And you wanna sweat those down just a little bit, because we don't wanna be biting into crunchy onions. All right, this is a dip. We want everything to be nice and mellow. All right, so look, once you sweat those down a little bit, we're gonna add in 1 stalk of celery. We wanna make sure that is chopped very finely. If you don't like celery, you can definitely leave that out, but you don't want to leave these out, okay? Add in 1/4 cup of bell peppers. I'm using red and green, but you can use green by itself or red by itself or yellow or orange, whatever you want to do, okay? It's up to you. Just make sure you add in your bell peppers and your onions and your celery, all right? And what I tell y'all all the time, season your aromatics, okay? Season them. It's nice to have layers of flavor. It's okay. And we're going to add in 1 tablespoon of minced garlic, and we're doing that last so we don't what? Burn it, all right? You don't want to burn the garlic. So once we get all of that going, y'all, you see this little part right here in the center? That's good stuff. We want that. So we're going to deglaze this pan by adding in a little bit of wine. I put 1/4 cup of wine in there. Look how it just comes up. It just lifts off the surface. All of that good flavor is now in your onions. It's in the skillet, and we want this to be delicious, all right? Now, if you don't want to use wine, you don't have to. You can use chicken broth, veggie broth, beef broth, whatever kind of broth you want, seafood stock, or just a little bit of water, all right? But the wine is best, okay? So look, now we're going to add in 6 ounces of lump crab meat, okay? Lump crab meat. This is the white meat. Add some of that in there. And we're going to add back in our cooked salmon. So you guys know that our crab meat is already cooked, so we don't have to cook it anymore. So that's why it went in last. And we're adding in our cooked shrimp. So all of our proteins are here. You want to just pop those in. And now we're going to start building these flavors, y'all. So look, you need about 8 ounces of cream cheese. This is not optional. All right, 8 ounces of cream cheese, and just allow the cream cheese to melt by just folding it in, just gently fold it in. And you may want to go ahead and reduce your heat to about medium low, because you don't want this to burn or stick. All right, so once you get your cheese in there, you want to add 1 heaping tablespoon of mayonnaise. Get you some good mayonnaise, not that crap. Get you some real mayonnaise, all right? And then add in 1 teaspoon of Creole seasoning for some flavor, 1 teaspoon of smoked paprika for extra flavor, and also 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper for extra flavor. Okay, stop playing. Y'all know what it is. And we're going to add in some lemon juice, because we want to tie all these flavors together. And you can't have seafood without lemon. Come on. We're also going to add in 1 tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce. Uh-oh, I might have said it right. 1 tablespoon of hot sauce. If you don't like the spice, you can definitely leave that out. And you just want to combine this, okay? Look, I told y'all, go ahead and reduce your heat to about low, medium, low. Because like I said, you have it up too high, you'll burn the bottom. I kind of did that. Don't tell nobody, all right? I'm adding in some parsley just for a little color. You know, nothing special, just a little color. You know, give it a nice little color because it looked kind of funny right now. But I promise you, baby, in the end, you are going to enjoy this. You are going to love this, all right? So once you get everything in there, smooth that baby out because we are about to top this off with some cheese. Do y'all hear me? Some cheese, some good cheese. I'm going to give it about a cup of mozzarella cheese. Now, I don't like to cover the entire surface. I just kind of like to put it in the center and leave the edges out. You can cover the entire surface and make a crust. You can use the whole pack of cheese, is that what you want? And the whole pack is 2 cups, but I'm only using half of each, all right? But it's totally up to you. However you want to put your cheese on there, that is fine, all right? I'm adding a little bit of paprika for coloring. This is just regular paprika. And we're going to bake this at 400 degrees Fahrenheit for 10 to 12 minutes until it's nice and gooey. And y'all, y'all listen, it was bubbly. But I let it rest a little bit because I had to go tend to some business. But let's go ahead and plate this up and then we'll talk about it. And there we have it, y'all. Hey, our ultimate seafood Creole dip, whatever you want to call it, baby. It is it. Look at that delicious dip. Every bite was amazing. I toasted up some baguette, and honey, we had us a good old time eating this dip. All right, it's already gone. That's sad, right? But look, anyway, I want to thank you guys for watching. Thank you so much for checking out my recipe. And if you tried, let me know how it went down in the comments. All right, and I'll see y'all next time in the next video. Bye.